A very good evening and good day to all my fellow travelers, photographers and friends around the world. Welcome to Chris Lee Travel Channel. I wish you all in good health. Now, in this episode of my travel to Kashmir, India, our tour for today will focus mainly on the places of interest at the outskirts of Srinagar. Which namely the Pari Mahal, as can be seen in this image. Second site will be the Mughal-era, it's actually a gardens. And lastly, the Gulmarg Hill Station cum Skid Resort, which is 49 kilometers away from Srinagar. Let's take a look at this map of India, a South Asian nation with a lot to offer to their visitor. Now, the location of this northern state of India, Jammu and Kashmir, is been highlighted by the red circle line. Now, the location of this northern summer city of India, the Srinagar, is as highlighted in this regional northern Indian maps. But take a closer look of it. Now, to begin with our journey to this scenic region, let me share some facts of this summer city of northern India, Srinagar. Now, visitors should not miss the listed places of interest when visiting Srinagar, which I'm going to share with you, particularly the Mughal-era gardens, namely the Mughal-era, which I'm sharing with you today, the Shiling Ma Ba, as well as Cheshire Shahi's gardens, the other two which I'm not sharing. Now, the Pari Mahal, which is top on our visiting list today, and also the another Asian style bazaar of the name Lachop Market, which also equally interesting. And on top of that, you should also cover the Sri Shankaracharya Ji Temple, as well as the historical wooden Jama Mosque in Srinagar City. Now, in order to cover all these places at leisure pace and time, visitor will need at least 2 full days, is my personal recommendation. And spring and summer season, which is from March to September, are ideal for gardens and countryside visit with large green fields, colorful blossom flowers everywhere. Now, it's the best season for visiting the Mughal-era garden here, where during the winter season, that it offers again a very different kind of feel and ambience. Indeed, Srinagar is suitable for travel in all 4 seasons. And being a summer city, right? The summer seasons is always the peak season for this city. So if you were to come during this season, please make well ahead of or reservation of your hotel stay and other related items. Now, just want to inform my viewer, Lachop Market is a central Asian style bazaar in Srinagar City, which I will not share with you today. Now, this place has been regarded as a shopper paradise. The market offers a variety of traditional Kashmiri handicraft. Now, items most sought after by tourists are hand-woven silks, embroidered saw, silver jewelry, bamboo and wooden items, carpets, and as well as dry fruit and nuts, which mostly cover the almonds and walnuts. As for fresh food, the Kashmir apples and the walnut if you were to travel during the late summer. Now our first travel stop for today is Pari Mahal. Let's take a look at this place. Now before we begin our journey to this Pari Mahal, let's take a look at this simplified map of Srinagar at Dal Lake regions. Please note the whereabout of Pari Mahal is located in location mark A on this map. Now, Pari Mahal or Pari Mahal, whichever the people like to call it, is a seven-layer terrace garden, well known as the Palace of Fairies or Abode of Fairies, whichever it is. It is located at the top of Zabawan's mountain range, overlooking the city of Srinagar and also at the southwest of Dal Lake in Jammu and Kashmir state. Now, due to its strategically location, right, this place is being placed under the guard of the Indian Army, which I'm going to share with you. And the garden was sited, the garden site, sorry, was founded during the 17th century with very interesting historical stone structures. It's as much as a monument and is a splendid example of Islamic architecture during the Mughal Empire. And the showcase of rich history of the Mughal period. Now it is actually an ancient Buddhist monastery, right, which located inside the garden and was then converted into a school of astrology, and then a place for astrological learning as well as serve as observatory. Thus, it is not wrong to say that the Pari Mahal was once a Buddhist monastery before turning into a library and residence of Mughal prince. And then the garden was built around a small spring and houses vivid variety of flowers laid out in its terrace, but all missing in winter. Let's take a look at some of this image. You can see this the stone structure in these images. So you can see that the terracing of this Pari Mahal. Now at this point, right, the Pari Mahal offer excellent views, or rather a best viewpoint for visitor overlooking the magnificent Dal Lake and its surrounding mountains during the sunny day with a clear sky. Of course, it does not happen to us. So from the image itself, we did not manage to see far due to low visibility. Now these ancient monuments come garden is illuminated at night and can be seen from far from all parts of Srinagar. Now as our visit is during the winter months, thick mist have seriously affected the visibility, and nevertheless it does give you a very different kind of scene and feel. and with a human figure placed in the image, able to give viewer a sense of scale, so that from here you can see the how massive is this stone structure, right? Compare the size that you can see the drop at this image, assuming the figure, human figure, and you can see how many times the human figure height was built, you know, from this end wall. So indeed, is a misty day for us. It's all what we can see, alright, during our visit of the surrounding. Now we move to the second section or second stop of the day, and again, take a look of this map. Now the location of Mughal-era. But it means gardens, and it's actually the most popular garden, and just seated next to the eastern bank of Dal Lake, and at a location marked B, right? And you can see that there's one more garden high up itself, but the nearest to the lake, it basically it's this Mughal-era Gardens. Now this Mughal-era Garden is one of the three popular Mughal-era gardens, right? And also the largest garden among the three. It was built during the Mughal Empire in Persian architectures. Now the garden was laid out by Asaf Khan, the brother of Queen Noor Jahan, in the year 1636. Now Nishat-ba in Urdu language means garden of joys, gardens of greatness, and garden of delight. Now this garden is about 533 meters long by 322 meter wide, spread on an area of about 20 hectares of land. And it is surrounded by a stone and brick wall. Now, it also been arranged in a 10 terrace style, which about 5 to 6 meters wide, one above the others. Now the terraces are bedecked with beautiful flower beds. Of course, during our visit, all these flower beds were missing. Now the stylish rows of the fountainhead and gushing stream of water, which only can be seen during other season, except the winter months, which then flow down the succeeding terraces in cascades, and this have added right to the beauty and charm of these gardens. So now you can see here, this is one of the fountains, and further down is another fountain, which actually a much smaller one. This is all the fountain pool. So unfortunately, therefore, during our visit, these items were all missing. But the leafless tree, right, and the dry out field or gardens indeed added special touch to the lovely winter scene of this garden that fronting the Dal Lakes. Only you will see and you will experience during the winter months. Now, so you can see here, these are the image that you walk around in this big garden compound. You can see the mark of the flower beds in this image. And here, you know, this is one of the tourists, right? And this is basically, if I'm not wrong, it should be the second tourist. Now, of the 10 tourists, the second tourist is considered the most impressive in view of the 23 niche on provided in the arch recess just behind the casket. Unfortunately, I've not managed to capture this image to share with you. Now, another interesting feature of this Nashat Bat is of the many marble throne like set up placed at the head of the waterfall across the channels. Again, I'm sorry that it's not in these images. And it's important to note that at this point, you know, at this platform, the second terrace, that it provides a commanding view of Dal Lakes and to able to see not only the lakes but also the snow-capped peak of Pampanja Mountains. Again, it's missing in our images due to low visibility. Now, our visit was in the morning, right? And with the perfect sunshine of the morning sun, have tinted the entire garden and its surroundings into a very, rather an unbelievably beautiful and dramatic scene with a unique perspective, a kind of leafless tree sanctuary. Of course, in the eye of photographer, now this is the most beautiful section of the gardens, which I'm going to bring to you. Here's this image. You can see that with the row of fully grown tree, the on both sides, you know, and form a leading line of the images. More for you to look, have a look. Indeed, this is one of my favorite image taken during the trip. This as well. So we can have more tree protection, as I like to call it. Okay, finally, we are moving on to our last stop of the day. There's a Gulmarg Hill Station, come Skid Resort. Now, let's look at this Google Maps, which is showing the Kashmir Valley region of northern India. Please note the location of Gulmarg towns, which mark B. Is located west of Srinagar, which mark A. So the distance between the A and B is 49 km apart. So Gulmarg is a town as well as an exquisite hill station and ski resort in the Kashmir Valley, and is approximately 49 km west of Srinagar by road, while Tamak, another small town, midway, right? And this Gulmarg town is situated in the Pampanja range in the western Himalayas and lie between the boundary of Gulmarg Wildlife Sanctuary, now under the administration of Gulmarg Development Authority. And of course, the last 10 kilometers before reaching Gulmarg town is literally ascending all the way. And Gulmarg in Kashmiri simply means middle of flowers. Now, during summer, this town and the surrounding areas are filled with large green meadow and wildflowers. In winter months, this region is covered with endless snowfields. As such, it is not only a popular ski resort, but also regarded as the seventh best ski destination in Asia. And therefore is well known as the heartland of winter sport in India, and this image was actually taken from the visitor parking area. Now the Gulmarg town is about 0.5 km away from the cable car base stations. This beautiful town render opportunity to reconnect with nature, find peace of mind and see a new face of Indian cultures. And of course, walking through this 0.5 km trail was a pain for many of us, as certain stretch of this trail was coated with ice from overnight. Our shoes were not prepared and meant for walking on icy surface, thus some of us have a fall, and I almost have a good fall as well. In this stretch of the road, you can see that the chain link fence next to the road was fully coated with ice. This totally didn't give us any chance to walk on those non-icy surface, even though just a short stretch, because the entire road was just covered with ice. Everybody had to walk through this icy surface. That is a killing part for many of us. And therefore, it's important to note that the Gulmarg town is full of hotels and rest houses to cater for the large number of visitors during the summer months. Now, we have a late lunch at these hotels, which I'm going to share later on before returning. So let's proceed on later on with other images. Now, the ski resort equipped with cable car, right? Or the local like to term it the gondola, which to ferry the skier and visitor to a mid-hill of Mount Alfhawat. It's divided into two stages, the lower and upper stages. Now the cable car or the gondola route is one of the longest and highest roadways in Asia, right? Reaching to a height of 3,979 meters. Above sea level. These two-stage ropeways ferry about 600 people per hour between the Gulmargs and on a shoulder of the nearby Alfhawat peaks, which about 4,200 meters above sea level. Of course, my visit covered only the lower sections. That is the first stage of the cable car or the ropeways. The upper section is mainly for skier. So in this stage, the so-called the first stage, there is a sea timber at the lower section of the hill stations. Now before we proceed with this image, I want to share with you on my experience on that day. Now it was surprisingly have a long queue at the cable car station on that day, and later on I realized that the long queue was because the operator, the cable car operator, gave the priority to the transportation of construction material. I believe there's some construction activity in the hill station, and therefore they just deprive the visitor from taking the cable car, not until all the construction material was transferred up to the higher, meant to the destinations. And we was waited in a queue for nearly an hour, if not at least minimum 40 minutes. So I will say it's a thumb down for these instances. Now, so the view from the cable car is truly commendable, as is on the clear sky. If you have an opportunity to view on the clear blue sky, you could possibly witness the magnificent the Nanga Parbat, right, as well, right, the mountain range nearby and mountain peaks. These images are view captured while riding the cable car. We are looking down off the dry grass field. So finally, we arrive at our destination at the first stage of the ropeways of the hill resort. You can see the beautiful surrounding scenes right at this midway cable car station. So this image and all the subsequent images were captured at the lower stage, which I'm saying to you, the first stage of the hill resort, and I hope that you will like it. So be prepared if you are planning to visit Srinagar, then if you also want to visit Gulmarg, then you must get yourself prepared for the need to walk on the snow, right? Or possibly you can even take part in some of the skiing activity during the winter activity. You could find some tiny black spot if you look carefully in these images at far. These are all the visitor, tiny human figure. This image is much clearer now. At the right bottom, you can see that there are some people there. Here you can find almost every corner in this image. There are not many foreign visitors during our visit. Instead, we found a lot of domestic visitors. You can see the Himalaya mountain peaks at far at the background. And remember, in my earlier, I have said that you could, you have time, you can also visit this Shiv temple, a small temple, but it's quite historical. Temple may worth visiting if you have the spare time. And here is basically the hotels that we are putting, not putting a night, but we are having our late lunch here. Okay, besides just exploring the hill station, I think more importantly that we also should also enjoy the surrounding along the journey from Srinagar to Gulmarg. And in this case, I'm going to share with you the countryside scenery taken during my journey from Srinagar to Gulmarg, which took place during the morning hours. And while driving on this journey to Gulmarg, so you can see these are the images, roadside images. We managed to put a stop or two along the way to capture this country scene. You can see as far the mountain range, the snow-capped mountain range. Some of the field farmlands, and this almost close to Gulmarg at the highest point now. Then when we are on our return journey from Gulmarg to Srinagar, which took place in the late afternoon, then as usual we also were stopped by along the way. We found some interesting scene, and these are the, some of the scenery taken during the afternoon, late afternoon hours. The images are much warmer in the afternoon. And of course, every time when I embark on an overseas journey, I always encounter surprises, right? And there's no exemption for this trip as well. So now I'm going to share with you of my surprises that I encounter during this trip or this section of my journey. While we are driving downhill and then we spotted quite a number of those Kashmiri ladies was carrying firewood on their heads. And I believe that this is important because that during the winter months, they require even much more firewood besides used for cooking, but also for keeping warm. So these ladies will then go to the forest nearby and collect all this dry three branches and then stack and pack them nicely and carry on their forehead walking down. And and why we are spotting many of these lady along the routes, then suddenly we spot these two young men, or rather quite a youth, was actually right in front of our car. And and basically they are actually just sit on a trolley and with the firewood placed on it, and they are gliding down the downhill slope. And I found that well, I could say, well, it's a smart move, but it's also a very dangerous move. What happens if there's an oncoming car and I didn't see any way they can stop this trolley or the car. My only way is using their 2 foot, you know, the feet, you know, and then to press hard on to the surface of the roads. But this will not stop the car or this trolley immediately. And you look at another image. This image was taken while we are overtake them, right? So you can see literally it's just nothing at all. Just sit on it and lay grind down along the way is what uncalled for action, which I hope that please do not follow. It's going to be quite risky, you know, to get themselves accident could happen, you know, if they are unlucky enough. And as usual, in every trips that I will then have collected some of my favorite images, and I would like to call it the abstract of the trip, or the trip abstract, whichever we call it. So I'm going to share with you now of my photo that I like best in this session of my journey. It give you a true winter scene, but in here it give you a autumn scene. But why in the Gulmarg you will have the winter scene? So that is all about what I'm going to share with you for this second episode of my travel journey to India, right? And in the next episode, it will be a new nation again, and I will not let you know, keep it in suspense, because I in the midst of deciding which nation to share with you, because I still have quite a number of recently completed journey to various parts of the country, such as the Japan and a country like revisit the China, the Sichuan. All these places are very, very interesting. Also like Indonesia to the Eastern Jawa. So I haven't decided which should be in the lineup. So please stay tuned. I will let you have the surprise of which nation I'm going to share with you in my coming episodes. So before I end, right, I would like to wish you in good health, and please stay safe and stay strong. And I shall see you next week. And bye.